Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the Poisson's equation for the unidirectional heat flow for the infinitely long solid cylinder. Now, initially we are going to consider one cylindrical portion whose inside radius is small r and outside radius is the capital R. Now, here the direction of the heat flow is in radially outward direction. So that's why I have shown here inside in, that is QR, and QR is the amount of heat which is supplied from the center of the cylindrical portion towards the outward in the radial direction. So here QR, we are getting heat conducted into the cylindrical portion in radial direction, in outward direction. Okay, so this is heat supplied, and QR plus dr is the amount of heat which is coming out from the cylindrical portion. Next, we are saying the small elemental section we are considering which generate Q1 amount of heat. Okay, so you can find here the amount of heat supplied, that is QR, and the amount of heat generated Q1 is equal to QR plus dr. Keep in mind, whatever the heat we are supplying over here, that is utilized to generate some amount of the heat inside this element, and remaining will be released into the atmosphere. So here we have done, as we have told, that is QR, that is heat conducted into the element per unit time. As per our Fourier law, we know that Q is equal to minus K dT by dx. Same law we are applying for this radial section. So QR is equal to minus K dT by dr. Instead of x, we are considering the radial portion. That's why we have taken dr. Next, QR is the heat conducted out of the elemental area per unit time. So for this QR plus dr, whatever the initial heat introduced over there, plus derivation of this minus K dT by dr with respect to dr, we are going to consider. So this is the heat, initially heat supplied, plus derivation of this small elemental area we are going to be considered. So after derivation, we are substituting the area we are considering, that is 2 pi RL for this cylindrical portion. Just we are substituted over here, area in this equation 2 pi RL, same way over here 2 pi RL. We are calling it as the equation number 7. Now, Q1 is the heat generated into the elemental area, as I have told, that is Q1. So this Q1 is the Q, whatever the heat amount of heat supplied into its volume, and that is the heat generated inside this cylindrical portion. So I have taken Q1 is equal to Q bar into volume of element. So I have substituted the volume. What is the volume of this small elemental ring? It is 2 pi RL into whatever the dr, that is the small elemental area, dr radius, that we are going to be taken over here. So 2 pi RL is the length, and the thickness we are considering, that is dr, and this gives you the Q1, that is heat generated inside this volume. So we know QR value, we know QR plus dr, we know the Q1. So by applying this steady state condition, what is my steady state condition? Whatever the heat you are going to be supplied to any system, that heat will be uniformly distributed inside that elemental area, or we are saying that much amount of the heat is released into the atmosphere. So as per this steady state, there is no any kind of the heat generation or the we are considering the amount of heat we are going to be supplied that will be released into the atmosphere. So in steady state condition we are writing the energy balance equation. Energy balance equation means what? The amount of heat supplied is utilized for which purposes? That part we are going to be equate over there. So that's why we are writing over here QR plus Q1 is equal to QR plus DR. So here we are saying, as we have been told, QR is the amount of heat supplied plus Q1 amount of heat generated. So generated heat and supplied heat is the included into the atmosphere, that is QR plus DR. So this is the energy balance equation. So as we have found out all these terms, just we have to substitute in this equation QR plus Q1, which is equal to QR plus DR. So as after substitution, this 2 pi RL, this get cancelled, and after rearranging the terms, we get 1 upon R d by dr into bracket R into dt by dr plus 2 by k is equal to 0. And this is the Poisson's equation for unidirectional heat flow in infinitely long cylinder. So this equation is very much important while solving the problem. When there is a heat generation, you are going to use this equation. Okay, so next part, same way, this equation we have derived for the cylindrical area. Now we are going to be derive this equation for solid sphere also. Okay, the diagrammatic representation is the same way, that is QR is the amount of heat supplied, R is the radius inside, capital R is the outside radius, dr is the thickness of that small elemental area, Q is the amount of heat coming from center towards the outward direction in the radial flow, and QR plus dr, that is the heat coming outside there. So all these factors again we are considering for the solid sphere also. So QR, heat conducted into the elemental area. Just difference between this derivation and this derivation is the area. Other derivation is the same as it is. So we are finding QR is equal to minus KA dT by dr. We are calling it as a equation number 1 over here. So this gives you the heat conducted into the element. Okay. Next we are going to find out QR plus dr, heat conducted out of the element. So that is QR plus dr is equal to minus KA dT by dr plus d by dr into bracket minus KA dT by dr into dr. We are calling at as equation number second. Before that we have to substitute the value of area, and here we are going to be consider the area for this spherical section 4 pi r square, and we have considered in this derivation area is the 2 pi r l. The difference is only this one. So we are going to substitute the area 4 pi r square, and we are getting equation number second. In next step we are going to find out heat generated. Heat generated is equal to Q bar into volume. Q bar volume we are considering 4 pi r square into dr, because we are considering again small elemental area of that spherical section. So we get here Q bar into the volume. We are calling it as equation number third. Next, as per the steady flow equation for this cylindrical portion, QR plus Q1 is equal to QR plus dr, means amount of heat supplied plus amount of heat generated, that is the heat coming outside the elemental area. So after substitution this, we know the QR. QR we are finding equation number 1, then QR plus dr equation number 2nd, and Q1 we are finding. After substitution all the terms in this equation, we got the Poisson's equation for the unidirectional heat flow for the bar dr plus q bar upon k, which is equal to 0. And this is the Poisson's equation for steady heat flow in unidirectional wave for the spherical section. Here in this section we have considered the heat generation part. Here small elemental area, here heat generation we are considering. So today we have discussed two derivation. One is the for cylindrical portion and second one is the for the spherical section. So the end equation, this equation for the cylindrical section and this equation for the spherical section, these both equations are very much important while solving the problem, because in the problem they are going to give you the radius, inside radius, outside radius. At that time you have to substitute the values and find the amount of heat flow. Okay, so these are all about the today's lecture. Thank you very much.